There are four main incisions that are offered for breast augmentation. The most common one is still a small incision underneath the breast. And that's our go-to incision for people with difficult case. Maybe there's asymmetry or something like that. And the reason why is it gives the most control because the implant is right where the incision is. This is how the operation started. It's still the most common incision type offered nationally, locally, and in my own practice. It is a very small incision, and I literally close them with my magnifying loop so that in 3 or 4 months there should be very little scar to notice at all. We can use that incision for saline or silicone implants, and the implant rests under the breast and the muscle there. The least popular incision, at least in my own practice, is around the areola. We call this a periareolar incision. It tends to be a little less popular among patients because there is going to be a higher chance of nipple numbness since the surgery is being performed right by the areola. Also, if a patient has a very small areola, we can't use that because we may not be able to make a long enough incision to get the implant in, particularly if we're using a silicone implant. Last of all, since we're going straight through the breast, there's a little bit more disruption of the breast, and if a woman is hoping to breastfeed in the future, that may negatively impact her chances. On the other hand, when we go under the arm or around the bottom of the breast, that has the least effect on the breast. And I tell my patients that even though these are called breast implants, it's really more proper to call it a behind-the-breast implant because we're not disrupting the breast at all from below or under the arm. We're simply lifting it forward and putting the implant behind it.